गुड इवनिंग ऑल, वेलकम टू अन अकाडमी। गुड इवनिंग वंस अगेन। So this is Bhanu Prakash, expert in GATE and ASC coaching. I did M.Tech from NIT Kurukshetra. I have 10 years of teaching experience and I train many students throughout our country for different competitive exams like GATE and ASC. My subjects are electrical machines and power electronics. BPC10 is my referral code. So use this code, you will get 10% discount on the Plus subscription as well as a Iconic subscription. And what are the benefits of the Plus and Iconic subscription? So by taking Plus subscription, you can get live classes from the top educators of the country. And also you can get structural schedule for 3 months, 6 months, 12 months and 24 months. And unlimited practice questions per subject wise and topic wise. Similarly, test series per subject wise and topic wise. Another subscription is a Iconic subscription. So by taking Iconic subscription, so you can get some additional features. Okay, in addition to these four, so you can get personal coach, study planners, expert guidance, ESC mains, questions and answers. So personal coach means we will assign a coach and he will guide everything until you get a job or until you crack the exam. And also we will provide the proper study planners, that means how to get the rank in the GATE and how to get ASC rank. Okay, next one, expert guidance, the ASC mains, questions and answers. Okay, good evening Naishwar, good evening. So BPC10 is my referral code. Okay, use this code, you will get 10% discount on Plus subscription as well as Iconic subscriptions. Okay, good evening all. So what is the price for the Plus and Iconic subscription? For GATE and ASC, Plus subscription is available for the 12 months, 18 months and 24 months. For 12 months, fee is at 27,225 rupees. For 18 months, fee is a 34,650 rupees. And for 24 months, fee is at 39,600 rupees. Okay. And next one, for Iconic subscription, it is available for 12 months and 24 months. Okay. For 12 months, the fee is at 45,225 rupees. And for 24 months, fee is 66,600 rupees. So this is the price for the Plus and Iconic subscription. And one more is to access pre-live classes in the Unacademy app. So go to Play Store and the search Unacademy Learning app and install in your phone. So you will get the pre-live classes and also you will get the subscription Plus classes also in the Unacademy app. So please install Unacademy learning app in your phone. So and enjoy with the pre-lesson classes. Okay. So this is the Plus batches taken by the top educators for EEE and EC. So one is the target ESC prelims, okay, 2021 electrical batch D, and another one is rank booster batch for the GATE 2021 EC batch D, and here another batch C is a target ESC prelims 2021 electrical batch C, here another rank booster batch for the GATE 2021 electrical batch B. So these are batches are going on for the electrical and EC branch. Okay, please take the subscription as early as possible. Okay, is that clear everyone?
Yes, Sanjana, good evening. Okay. So, in previous class, we had discussed about working of the DC generators and EMF equation. And after that, we had discussed what are the observations from the EMF equation and working of the DC generators here. So, one of the observation is a EMF induced in the armature of the DC generator is a the sinus time varying nature of the induced EMF or AC nature of induced EMF. Yeah. So this part we have discussed in the earlier class. And second one is a the frequency of the EMF induced in the armature of the DC generator F is equal to PN by 120, where P is the number of the poles and N is the speed of the generators. Yeah. And another one, so in the generator, another one, so this generated voltage is directly proportional to product of the speed and the main field flux phi f. So this equation you can rewrite easy 2 divided by easy 1. So that equal to n2 divided by n1, the multiplied by phi f2 divided by phi f1 here. So what is this n1 and n2? Okay, n1 is the speed of the generator at one steady state operating point, and next n2 is the speed of the generator at another steady state operating point. So similarly, phi f1 is a field flux at one steady state operating point, and phi f2 is a field flux at another steady state operating point. Now this is the relation between the generated voltage in the generator from steady state operating point 1 to steady state operating point 2. So this is the another observations from the EMF equation of the DC generator. So another one, it's a very important. So in the generator also motoring action takes place. Okay, in the generator also motoring action takes place. So due to which electromagnetic torque produced in the armature of the DC generator. So this torque is a the electromagnetic torque so produced in the armature of the DC generator by motoring action. So now another torque in the generator, it is the prime mover torque. Okay, this is the TPM, is a the prime mover torque. So here this prime mover torque is a the driving torque of the generator. It drives the armature of the DC generator. That's why it is called as a driving torque of generators. All of you got it? Okay, next one, the TEM is a electromagnetic torque produced in the generator. So this is a opposing torque of the generators. Okay, it is another question. We have a question here. The TEM in the sense electromagnetic torque produced in the generator, which opposes the prime mover torque. That's why it is treated as an opposing torque of the generator. Now, what about the prime mover torque? Prime mover torque is a driving torque of the generator. It drives the armature of the generators. Got it? So, for stable operation, so always TPM in case of the generator, okay, generator. So TPM is greater than or equal to electromagnetic torque. So for the stable operation, okay, this is a very one of the question in the computer exam. For stable operation of the generator, always driving torque should be greater than or equal to the opposing torque. Okay. Sure. Nenu kuda classes, special class lo already nenu synchronous machines lo chala class cheppanu. Question series synchronous machines lo cheppanu. Meeru okasari chudandi meeku telusu. Meeru oka anacademy app download chesukoni okasari chuste meeku chala classes, chala question series nenu synchronous machine lo cheppanu. Okay, Sanjana. సింక్రనస్ మిషన్స్ లో క్వశ్చన్ సిరీస్ లాస్ట్ మంత్ లో నేను క్లాస్ తీసుకున్నాను. ఈ ఈ మంత్ లో కూడా క్వశ్చన్ సిరీస్ చేస్తాను. హావ్ యూ గాట్ ఇట్ మై పాయింట్? So this part we have discussed yesterday. Complete the EMF induced in the armature is a the AC nature, frequency, generated voltage, and also which is the driving torque of the generator. This is one of the question, and which is the opposing torque of the generator. This is another possibility question in the synchronous machine. Okay. Okay. Sure. I will do it. ట్రాన్స్కో పార్ట్నర్ లో చేయండి, సర్చ్ చేస్తాం. ట్రాన్స్కో జెన్కో పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యూలో ఒక స్పెషల్ బ్యాచ్ చేసి అలా క్వశ్చన్స్ మేము చెప్తాం స్పెషల్ క్లాస్. క్వశ్చన్ డి వాంట్ టు ఆస్క్? Okay, listen. So in this class we will discuss about the working of the DC motor and its torque equation. What is the meaning of working of the DC motor? How does torque produce in the DC motor? That is the meaning of working. And also how does rotor rotates in the how does armature rotates in the DC motor? So this is the meaning, exactly meaning of the working of the DC motor. So what is the terminology used in this diagram? So one is a this N comma S. Okay, these are the field poles. So why field poles are required in the DC machine? Yesterday we have discussed the field poles are required to create the magnetic flux or to create the flux in the machine here. And this is a ABCD. Okay, here A. And this is the AB is a one conductor, and this is the CD is a another conductor here. So ABCD is a the single turn armature coil. Okay, it is a armature coil. Okay, armature coil. It is a single turn, the single turn coil. For example, point we have taken as a the one single turn coil. The single turn coil formed by using the two conductors. AB is a one coil side and CD is a another coil side. So what is the meaning of single turn coil? If each coil side of a coil contains single conductor, then the coil is said to be single turn coil. Suppose double turn coil. So what is the meaning of double turn coil? If each coil side of a coil contains two conductors, then the coil is said to be double turn coil. Or sometimes we have a question, multi-turn coil. What is the meaning of multi-turn coil? If each coil side of a coil, for example, AB contains two or more conductors. Similarly, CD contains two or more conductors. So this type of coil is known as a multi-turn coil. So for our convenience, here we have taken single-turn coil. So which has AB is a one coil side and CD is a another coil side. So AB coil side is connected to the commutator segment C1. Okay, and this is the commutator segment C1. Another one is connected to the commutator segment C2 here. So this is the commutator segment. So one is a C1 commutator segment. Another one is a C2 commutator segment. So braces are placed on the commutator. So this brace is the B1 brace and the B2 braces here. So braces, okay, provide the electrical connection between the internal circuit as well as the outer circuit here. So for example, in the generator, the brace collect the current from the commutator and deliver to the load. But in case of the motor, what is the exactly function of the braces? So brush collect the current from the source and deliver to the commutator segment. So these are the terminology used in the DC motors here. So what will happen exactly whenever the DC motor is excited with the DC supply here? So when the DC motor is excited with the DC supply, so this DC supply is denoted by V, okay? So supply VDC here. So whenever DC, the motor is excited with the DC supply, the here brush collect the current. So there is a function of the brush. So these brushes collect the current from the source and deliver to the commutator. So now this is a brush collect current. Okay, this is a collect the current from the source and deliver to the commutator segment. So now after that, current here passes to the commutator segments. Okay, this is the commutator function. So what is the commutator function in the motor? So commutator converts the DC current to the AC current in case of the motor. But in case of the generator, commutator converts AC current to the DC current and act as a converter. So here commutator converts the DC to the AC current and act as a inverter here. So and after that, armature coil or armature winding here. So current flows in the armature coil. The which current flows in the armature coil? The AC nature of the current flows in the armature coil. So once current carrying conductor placed in the stationary magnetic field, and what will happen? The torque produced. Okay, this is the force developed by the conductor. Okay, this force developed by conductors here. So this the twisting moment of force about an axis. Okay, torque will be developed. So this torque is a electromagnetic torque produced by the motor. So this torque drives the rotor. Okay, drives the armature of the DC machine, armature conductors or armature core. So now that's why this electromagnetic torque in the motor is treated as a driving torque of the motors. Okay, all of you got it? So I repeat once again, listen. So initially supply is given to the braces. Okay, whenever brush is collected here, so this is a whenever DC motor is excited with the AC supply, so this is a positive supply. So now here is the positive group of the braces and the negative group of the braces here. So now current positive group brush and negative group of the braces. So now this C1 commutator is a positive, so that current flows from the A to B terminal, and the current the flows in the CD conductor from C to D terminals here. So whenever current away from observer, so it is denoted by cross mark. Okay, am I right? So now whenever current away from the observer, this is denoted by the cross mark here. Current flows in the AB conductor is cross mark. Now current flows in the CD conductor, okay, this is a dot mark. Okay, so this is the flux lines, main field flux lines are passing from always north pole to the south pole. This is the direction of the main field flux lines. So whenever a current carrying conductor placed in the stationary magnetic field, the force developed by the AB conductors as well as force developed by the CD conductors here. So that twisting moment of force about an axis is a torque developed in the armature. So this torque will rotate the armature of the DC motor. So this is a step by step function. So DC supply, brushes, commutator, current flows in the armature coil, force developed, and then after torque, and this torque will drive the armature of the DC motor. Okay. So from here we can say that current flows in the armature coil. So due to the supply, okay, current flows in armature coil. Armature coil, okay, is from A to B terminal, okay, in a b conductor, a b conductor, so it is denoted by the cross mark, right? So this is the cross mark here, away from the observer. So similarly, okay, from the b, the receive from the c to d terminal, okay, terminal, so in the cd conductors, so how do we represent this current towards the observer? So it is denoted by the dot mark, okay, cross mark and the dot mark. So all of it clear now? So what is the mean by cross mark and dot mark? So always the whenever field winding is excited with the DC supply, so flux lines are always close from the north pole to the south pole. So let us assume this is the north pole, okay, N, okay, and this is our the south pole, okay, north pole and south. So N comma S are the field poles. So always flux lines are passing from north pole to the south pole. So this is the direction of the flux flows in the magnetic field. So this main field flux lines, okay, phi f, which flows from the north pole to the south pole here. All of you got it point? So this is the main field flux lines phi f, okay. So now at this instant, so conductor AB, the conductor AB conductor, which is under the influence of the north pole. So as so see in this figure, conductor AB is under the influence of the north pole and conductor CD is under the influence of the south pole. So now which is nearer to the north pole and conductor CD is nearer to the south pole, okay, at this instant, okay, all of you got it? So now this is a one armature coil, so which has a two conductors, so one is the AB conductor and the CD conductor here. So next one, what about the current direction in this coil? The current flows in the AB conductor, the cross mark, current away from the observer. So that is denoted by cross mark at the AB conductor and the dot mark at the CD conductors here. So now according to Lorentz principle, okay, according to the Lorentz principle, so what will happen whenever a current carrying conductor, okay, this is a current carrying conductor, magnetic field. So according to Lorentz principle, the whenever a current carrying conductor is placed in the stationary magnetic field, so the force experienced by that conductor here. So that means force experienced by, okay, force experienced by the AB conductor and force experienced by the CD conductors here. So now how do we obtain direction of the force here? Is it Fleming's right hand rule or left hand rule? Can you tell me how do we obtain direction of this force? Nageshwar, Sanjana, can you tell me this about this one? Direction of the force. How do we obtain the direction of the force? Very good. So Fleming's left hand rule. Now apply the Fleming left hand rule. So by applying the Fleming left hand rule, the force applied by the AB conductor, is it a downward direction or leftward direction? So this is a forefinger. Okay, see here. Forefinger, the forefinger represent the flux direction. And this center finger represent the current direction. So if we know this, if forefinger indicate the flux direction, center finger indicates the current direction, then thumb indicates the force developed by the conductors. So now force developed by the AB conductor, the is acts in the downward directions. Okay. Similarly, force developed by the CD conductor, forefinger indicates the flux direction, this is the center finger towards the observer, if we feel as a observer. So now this is the towards observer, this the thumb indicates the force developed by the conductors here. So now force developed by the CD conductor is upward directions, okay, so that you can write, so by FLR, okay, this is the FLR, the force developed by the AB conductors, developed by AB conductor, okay, so this is a downward direction, downward. Similarly, the pores developed by the CD conductor. So it acts in the upward direction. So now one pore is the downward. Okay, this pore is the downward and this pore is the upward. So what will happen? This twisting movement of pores about an axis. So is it a clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction? Can you tell me? One force is a downward, other force is upward. So that torque developed by the this electromagnetic torque developed by the motor. So is it in anti-clockwise direction? Very good. So now this is a the electromagnetic torque developed by the so this one is a electromagnetic torque. So developed by the motor. So which acts on the so therefore. The electromagnetic torque developed by the motor the acts in the anti-clockwise direction. So this electromagnetic torque drives the armature of the DC motor. So that's why it is treated as a the driving torque of the motors. Got it point? So this is treated as the driving torque of the motors. Got it? So if there is no driving torque in the motor, motor comes into the stop. Are you getting point? So to drive the rotor of the armature of the DC motor, which torque is required? Electromagnetic torque is required. If there is no electromagnetic torque in the machine, motor comes to stop. Okay. Okay, is that clear everyone? So this is exactly operating principle. So DC motor operates on the principle of the Lorentz law. The previous class we had discussed that part. So here, what is the Lorentz law? The whenever a current carrying conductor is placed in the stationary magnetic field, the force experienced by that conductor. So now this is a 1-by-1 step. So when DC supply is, whenever DC motor is exerted the DC supply, the brushes collect the current from the source and the commutator converts DC current to the AC current so that current flows in the armature coil. So now whenever this is a current flows in the armature coil from A to B terminal in the AB conductor and C to D terminal in the CD conductor. That means cross mark at AB conductor, dot mark at the CD conductor. So according to the Lorentz principle, okay, so this whenever a rotating conductor is placed in the stationary magnetic field, the force experienced by the AB conductor as well as CD conductors. How do we obtain the direction of the force? So direction of the force can be obtained by using the Fleming's left hand rule, okay. Slip rings are not the commutator segments, not the slip rings. Slip rings in case of the synchronous machine. Okay, actually, here slip ring in the sense, suppose it is a one shaft of the machine. Okay, Sanjana, mean this shaft and only, suppose it is a commutator, this one is the commutator segments, okay, like commutator segments, okay, commutator segments like so on. So now this is the armature coil. So man ela connect chesam, armature winding is connected to the commutator segments, okay, like so all the armature coils are connected to the commutator segment. So brush anedi directly the brush provide chestam. So brush nunchi brushes are stationary untai. కానీ కమ్యుటేటర్ ఆర్మేచర్ కాయిల్స్ రొటేట్ అవుతూ ఉంటాయి. సో మీరు కమ్యుటేటర్ ఆర్మేచర్ రొటేట్ అయినప్పుడు బ్రష్ కనెక్ట్ చేస్తున్నాం కదా, మీకు ఇక్కడ స్ప్లిట్ రింగ్స్ ఆర్ ప్రొవైడెడ్. ద ఎందుకు ప్రొవైడ్ చేస్తామంటే, సపోజ్ నువ్వు ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు న్యూట్రలైజ్ ద ఆర్మేచర్ రియాక్షన్ ఎఫెక్ట్, డిమాగ్నటైజింగ్ క్రాస్ మ్యాగ్నటైజింగ్ ఆర్మేచర్ రియాక్షన్ ఎఫెక్ట్, సో దేర్ ఇస్ ఏ ద వన్ కంపన్సేటింగ్ వైండింగ్ ఈస్ యూజ్. సో దిస్ కంపన్సేటింగ్ వైండింగ్ is connected in series with the armature winding. So armature is rotating, but compensating windings are placed in the pole shoe. Okay, so which are stationary. So impeding in the one is a stationary, other one is a rotating. So that's why, how do we connect these two are in the series? So these two are connected through slip rings. Okay, slip rings are. So this is the main function of the slip rings in the DC motors. But another function is there in case of the synchronous machine that I will discuss whenever we have a discussion about the synchronous machine. So slip rings are also used here, but so to connect, the compensating winding is placed in the pole shoe and which is connected in series with the armature winding. But armature winding is a rotating. So one is a stationary, other one is a rotating. How do we connect these two? So it is not possible. That's why embedded in the, so to connect these two in the series, there is a one slip ring. Okay, that is a, so it will place on the shaft of the machine. Are you clear now? I will discuss everything in details in the construction part of the DC machine. So this is a discussion about how does rotor rotates. So this question is our question is a how does rotor rotates? Rotates in DC motor. Okay, this is the question. So how does rotor rotates? So by the electromagnetic torque produced by the motor, the rotor of the DC motor will be rotated. That's why the electromagnetic torque is created as a driving torque of the motor. Okay, thank you. Okay, let's move on another one. So there is a one more question. So that is a motor generating action in the motor. Okay, this is a generating action in motor. So clear. So what is the meaning of generating action in the motor? So we know that what is the operating principle of the generator. So generator operates on the principle of Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. So it states that whenever a rotating conductor is placed in the stationary magnetic field, an EMF induced in that conductors. Now similarly, what is the operating principle of the motor? So DC motor operates on the principle of Lorentz force law. So what is the Lorentz force law? Whenever a current carrying conductor is placed in the stationary magnetic field, the torque produced in the motor or the force developed by the motor here. So this twisting movement of force about an axis, the electromagnetic torque produced. So which will rotate the armature of the DC motor. Okay, this part we have discussed. So what is the meaning of the generating action in the motor? Suppose first one, so there is a motoring action. Okay, here is a motoring action here. So what is the meaning of motoring action? So initially, so here a current carrying conductor placed in the stationary magnetic field. Okay, so after some time, okay, what will happen? So due to the motoring action, okay, electromagnetic torque produced in the motor. So this electromagnetic torque, okay, rotate the armature conductors. So which rotates armature conductors at a speed of armature conductor at a speed n. So under steady state condition, like in the speed is a n. So when the once rotate armature conductor is rotating, So what will happen here? This is the rotating conductor in the magnetic field. So rotating conductor in the stationary magnetic field. Stationary magnetic field here. So now this is the which action it is? So now this is called as the generating action. So now initially it is a motoring action. So now after that generating action. So that what we conclude here, in the generator also, in the motor also, generating action takes place. So due to which EMF induced in the armature. So this EMF opposes the applied voltage to satisfy the Lenz law. How does it takes place? So let us take one diagram here. So this is the north pole. Okay, see here all of you. So this one is the north pole here. Okay, north pole. So and this is our the south pole. So always flux lines are passing from the north pole to the south pole. So this diagram is a very important to analyze the entire DC machine concepts. If you know clear about this diagram, you can answer any type of question. So that is this one is the north pole and this is the south pole. So that here always flux lines are passing from so north pole to the south pole. This is the flux lines phi f. Okay, direction of the flux line, the phi f values here. So there is a conductor. Okay, AB conductors. Okay, we have mentioned here AB conductor. So which is placed nearer to the north pole. Similarly, the CD conductor, okay, which is placed in the south pole here. The current flows in the armature coil. Okay, current flows in the armature coil from A to B conductors. So that's why we can treat it as a cross mark. So from the C to the D conductor, that is a dot mark here, cross side dot. So it is a one armature coil. So according to the Lorentz force law, what will happen? A current carrying conductor placed in the magnetic field. So force developed by the AB conductors. Okay, this is the force developed by the AB conductors and force developed by the CD conductors. Okay, this is the direction of the force. So now here this is called electromagnetic torque in the motor. This is electromagnetic torque. So in case of the motor, okay, in the case of the motor. So once, okay, here is the force direction. So what will happen? We know that this is the force. Okay, force developed by the AB conductor as well as force developed by the CD conductors here. So I am writing with another pen. So whenever a rotating conductor is placed in the stationary magnetic field, so that EMF induced in the AB conductor, okay, AB conductor. So this EMF induced, okay, this EMF induced in the CD conductor by the generating action. So how do we get direction of induced EMF? So now here, so at this, at AB conductor, see, the at AB conductors, AB conductor, so what will happen? So EMF induced. So now here, this is a AB conductor. So I am writing here AB conductor. So this is the flux direction. Flux lines are passing. This is the direction of the flux. Okay, flux lines are. So next one. So this is the force direction. Okay, this one is the force. So flux lines phi and the force is the F here. So now let us find out the what about the EMF direction. Is it in the air, cross mark or dot mark? So forefinger indicate the flux. Okay, this is the direction of the four. Forefinger indicate the flux direction. The thumb indicate the force developed by the AB conductor. Then center finger indicate the current direction. So current towards the observer. Current, suppose current coming towards me. So that is a cross or dot mark. So now this one is the dot mark. Okay, this is the dot mark here. So now here is a dot. Okay, got it point? So initially this is the supply voltage terminal. Okay, this is a supply is given like this in the conductors. Okay, this is the direction of the positive supply and this one is the negative supply. That's why it is a cross the dot and here cross and the dot. So but here this EMF is a EMF direction. The here this is a direction of the EAB. Okay, direction of EAB. So that is a dot mark. Okay, dot mark A. Now similarly at the CD conductors, then what will happen? So at CD conductor, this is the already given here dot. No, it is the force developed by the conductor is upward. Now flux lines is a passing here. These are flux lines direction. So these are flux and this one is the force F. So now what about the current direction or EMF direction? It is a cross mark. So now direction of EAB here. So direction of the EAB. Okay, this is a dot mark here. So now these two are is opposes the applied voltage. So opposes the applied polarities of opposes polarity of the applied voltage. Applied voltage is here. So that's why this EMF is known as a back EMF of the motor or counter EMF of the motors. Okay. All of you got it point? What is the meaning of back EMF or counter EMF? Yes. So what we conclude here? In the motor also generating action takes place. Okay. In the motor also generating action takes place. In motor also generating action takes place. Due to which EMF induced in the armature. Induced in armature which opposes applied voltage. Okay, got it point? That's why okay, this EMF is known as which EMF here? Back EMF EB. Okay, or counter EMF. Okay, got it? So according to the Lenz law. Okay, this is according to the Lenz law. So which one is a cause? Tell me. Okay, according to the Lenz law. So which one is a cause and which one is a effect? According to the Lenz law, which one is a cause and which one is a effect in this discussion? Cause is, okay, effect is induced EMF. And what about the cause? Cause is applied voltage, induced EMF, EB, and applied voltage, the V. So this is the applied voltage, the V. Got it? Right. Effect is a induced EMF and cause is applied voltage. So what is the statement of the Lenz law? So here always the effect opposes very very cause producing it. So because of the supply voltage only EMF induced in the armature. Just imagine there is no applied voltage. So you know EMF induced in the armature coil. So that's why this induced EMF opposes the applied voltage to satisfy the Lenz law. Okay, so now the another question, magnitude of the back EMF. So this is the magnitude of back EMF. Okay, it is nothing but here generated voltage in armature. Okay, that's why we can write therefore easy is EB is equal to, so that is a easy, so that is a phi Zn by 60. Yesterday we have discussed this part. So pi Zn by 60 into P by A. So this is the magnitude of the back EMF in the DC motors. Okay, all of you clear now? So in the generator also motoring action takes place due to which EMF induced. So this EMF opposes the applied voltage to satisfy the Lenz law. Right. So next one. So what are the observations from this discussion? This is a very, very important, all possible questions. Observations from this discussion. Okay. So that means all the possible questions from the possible question from this discussion here. So first observation, tell me, so one is A, the current flows in the armature of the DC motor, is it AC nature or DC nature? Current flows in the armature of the DC motor, AC, very good. So now first one, we have observed that current flows in armature of the DC motor, is time varying nature. Okay. So that is a time varying nature, that is nothing but AC nature of the current. Okay. And next one, the frequency of the current flows in the air, frequency. So what frequency is same? Frequency of current flows in the armature. Flows in armature. So that is the F is equal to Pn by 120, where P is the number of the poles and also these are any the speed of the motors. Got it? So next another question. So in case of the DC motor, so this is a back EMF is, we know that here the back EMF EB is equal to, so this is a back EMF in the DC motor, back EMF EB is equal to phi Zn by the 60 into P by A, P by A here. So what we conclude here? So this phi is a, the Z is a number of conductors, P is a number of the poles. These are the fixed at the time of designing and we cannot change the number of conductors during operation of the motor. So therefore we can write the during operation of the motor. So this back EMF EB, the directly proportional to the field flux, product of the directly proportional to the field flux and the speed of the motors here. So this is a another observation from this discussion. So that you can write during operation, operation of the motor. So this is a back EMF EB directly proportional to product of the speed and the field flux of the motors. So from this equation you can write EB2 by EB1. So is equal to phi F2 divided by phi F1. So multiplied by N2 by N1 here. So if the flux is a constant, then EB is directly proportional to the speed of the motor only. Okay. All of you clear? This one is the third observation from this discussion. And next one, fourth observation. So how do we get fourth observation? So we know that, torque equations. That is a, so here torque equations of the DC motors. Okay, how do we get torque equation? See, so we know power developed in the any electrical machine. Power developed in any electrical machine. Okay, P is equal to the torque into angular speed. So now here torque is equal to P by, okay, this one is a torque is equal to, you can write P the divided by the N. So now we can write, so P is equal to power and this is equal to 2 pi N by 60. So that here, so P divided by 2 pi N by the 60. So now simplify here, the 60 by 2 pi N, so multiplied by power developed. So this is a developed power. So now power developed in the means power developed in the armature. So therefore torque is equal to the 60 by, okay, here is a 60 divided by 2 pi N. So multiplied by, so torque developed here, that is the EB, the multiplied by armature current. So how do we get this EB? So here EB is equal to 60 by 2 pi N. Okay, 2 pi N here. So next one, the 60 by 2 pi N back EMF of the motor. So now here this one is a back EMF, we can write. So pi Zn by 60, the into P by A. Okay, P by A. So multiplied by armature current IA. So now simplify. Okay, here is a N, the N will be cancelled out. Okay, this is a 2 pi N and N is cancelled out. The 60 is cancelled out. So now here is a, we can get, so this one is a, the torque equal to, okay, this is the torque developed by the motor, torque developed, okay, by the motor T, okay, this is equal to the 60, here C in this case, what will happen? So 60 is cancelled out. So now here is a ZP by 2 pi A. Okay, this one is the ZP by, okay, 2 pi A, okay, multiplied by 5 IA values here. So now it is a one constant, okay, number of conductors, number of poles and 2 pi A. So now this constant you can treat as a torque constant. So now T is equal to torque constant, so multiplied by 5 IA here. So now this is the torque constant TT here. So where KT in the sense, so that is equal to, so ZP by the 2 pi A values here. So where P is the number of poles, A is the number of parallel paths, Z is the number of the conductors. Okay. So this is the one method to derive the torque equations. So during operation, what will happen? So this is the during operation of the motor, operation of motor. So now this is equal to, okay, so torque is a constant, is a here, if you remove the proportionality constant, the torque is directly proportional to pi IA1. So this is a condition is a valid only during operation. So therefore you can write T2 by T1 is equal to, so phi only field flux, okay, so phi F2 divided by phi F1, so multiplied by IA2 divided by IA1. So where current in the at one steady state operating point, current in the another steady state operating point. So all of you clear my point? So this is the torque equation of the DC motors. Okay. Is that clear? Okay. Is it clear? So how do we get torque equation? And next, another observation, fifth one. Okay, fifth observation. It is a very, very important. So that is a relation between the electromagnetic torque and load torque TL in DC motor. Okay, so relation between the electromagnetic torque and TL in the load torque. So now what is the relation between these two, electromagnetic torque and load torque? So initially, let us assume, okay, let TEM in the sense what? Okay, TEM is a, so it is a electromagnetic torque. Electromagnetic torque produced by the motor. Produced by the motor in armature. Okay. So next one, this is what? So which drives the armature of the DC motor. So that's why it is treated as a the driving torque of the motors. Got it point? So this one is treated as the driving torque of the motor. Now similarly, so what about the TL? Okay, TL is a the torque imposed on the shaft of the motor. That is a mechanical load imposed on the shaft of the motor. So this one is a the torque load torque. Okay, load torque here. So it means that the total okay load torque here. So under this condition, so now exactly, so this one is a opposing torque. Okay, opposing torque of the motors. Okay, one is the driving torque and this one is the opposing torque. So actually in the picture, so shaft to torque is equal to T shaft. Okay, actually that shaft to torque is equal to the load torque TL plus frictional torque FR. Okay, friction. So now this is the complete shaft to torque of the motor. Shaft to torque is equal to, so this is the shaft to torque. So TCH, okay, shaft torque is equal to TL plus FR. So TL in the sense, okay, mechanical load impose, okay, mechanical load on the shaft, okay, on the shaft of the motor. So now shaft of the motor, that is a the TL. So what is the TFR here? Okay, it is a frictional torque. Okay, this one is the frictional torque. Got it point? So this is the treated as frictional torque. So it is a very small, okay, it is the very the small value here, very small value. So now that's why you can neglect it sometime, but there is a some frictional torque on the shaft of the motors. Okay, so got it point? So TEM is a electromagnetic torque produced by the motor, so which is driving torque of the motor. So TL is a load torque. Actual in practice, okay, so in practical, okay, in the practical, so what will happen? So here shaft to torque is equal to the load torque plus frictional torque. So but load torque is a very high as compared to the frictional torque. So frictional torque is a very small, so neglected for analysis point of view. So if frictional torque is neglected, so under no load condition, okay, suppose, so under no load of the DC motor, under no load of DC motor, what is the meaning of no load of the DC motor? So that means, okay, load torque is equal to zero. Okay, load torque is equal to zero. But only shaft torque is nothing but under no load. So that is a frictional torque. Okay, this one is the frictional torque only. So under no load condition, so what will happen? TL is equal to zero. Motor is, there is no mechanical load on the shaft of the motor. So at this condition, so TL is equal to zero. But there is a some frictional torque on the shaft. So which here, in order to produce this frictional torque, the motor draws very small amount of the armature current from the source. Okay. So that's why here is a, so very small amount of current is required to produce the very small amount to drive the this frictional torque. But in order to drive the load torque, very large amount of the current is required from the source. That means motor draws very large amount of the current to drive the load torque or to drive the mechanical load on the shaft of the motor. Okay. Is that clear now? There is a continuous, there is a one more discussion is there based on this concept. Very, very important. Are you clear now? What is the shaft to torque, load torque and frictional torque? yes, okay. So now we have a three conditions. One is a, so first condition one, okay, suppose, okay. So here, if electromagnetic torque produced by the motor, okay, electromagnetic torque, so is less than the load, okay, the electromagnetic torque less than the load torque, okay, then what it means here? So electromagnetic torque is, that is the driving torque is less as compared to the load torque, then what will happen? Okay, then, so what will happen in the machine? Okay, next one, second condition, so if the electromagnetic torque, so is greater than the load torque, then what will happen? Okay, and third one, okay, that is a third condition, so if electromagnetic torque the equal to the load torque, so then what will happen in the machine? So these are the three different conditions which is very useful to analysis purpose. Okay, suppose if electromagnetic torque less than the load torque means what? Driving torque of the motor is less than the opposing torque. Driving torque of the motor is less than the opposing torque. Then what will happen? Anybody? If driving torque of the motor less than the load torque, then what will happen in the machine? If driving torque of the motor is greater than the opposing torque, then what will happen in the machine? Similarly, another question, if electromagnetic torque is the less than the, so this is a electromagnetic torque is the less than the, or equal to the load torque, then what will happen in the machine? Okay, now tell me, Sanjana, Nageshwar, who are seeing this live, please tell me the answers. Second case is not possible, I think. No, no, if it is a possible, just expect. If it is happen, then what will happen? Whether it is possible or not, I will tell you that part. Okay, we will discuss when it is possible, when not it is possible, then I will discuss everything. But if it is happen, okay, driving torque is more than the load torque, then what happened in the machine? Reverse direction. No, 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 no. See, if electromagnetic torque less than the load torque, then what will happen? The motor will be deaccelerated. Okay, and hence speed of the motor decreases progressively. Okay. So I repeat once again, if electromagnetic torque less than the load torque, so then motor will be, okay, will be deaccelerated, okay, accelerated, and ends, okay, and ends speed of the motor, speed of motor decreases progressively, progressively, okay, so speed of the motor decreases progressively or gradually. So this, under this condition, okay, this mode of operation is known as a, so unstable operating mode, okay, this is nothing but unstable operating mode. Okay, we don't want to operate the machine, so in this mode, so why? Because always driving motor, driving, so driving torque should be greater than the opposing torque. So next one, so at this condition, if electromagnetic torque greater than the load torque, so what it means here? Driving torque of the motor greater than the opposing torque, so then motor will be accelerated. Okay, this is a motor. So will be accelerated, okay, and hence the speed of the motor increases progressively, speed of motor increases progressively, okay. So this mode of operation is known as a, the stable operating mode. Okay, next one,
If electromagnetic torque equal to the load torque, then what happened? So here is a opposing torque and the driving force, the torque are equal and opposite. Then what will happen? If electromagnetic torque and driving torque both are equal, that is the driving torque and opposing torque are equal, then what will happen? Steady state. Very good, Sanjana. That's correct. That's very good. So that means acceleration and deacceleration will be stopped. Okay, that means if the electromagnetic torque equal to the load torque, then motor is said to be under steady state condition and runs at the constant speed. Okay, here the speed of the motor is always constant, only rotated continuously at the same speed. So that is called as a steady state condition. So if electromagnetic torque equal to the load torque, then the motor is said to be, under steady state condition, okay, under steady state condition. All of you clear? If electromagnetic torque equal to the load torque, then the motor is said to be under steady state condition and runs at constant speed. Constant speed. Got it? So very, very important point, this one. So some people think that opposing torque equal to the load torque, so that motor comes to the stop. No, motor cannot come to the stop, but only acceleration or deacceleration will be stopped, but motor speed cannot be stopped. Okay, got it point? So that what we conclude here, so per stable operation of the motor, okay, this is the per stable operation of the motor, so now here torque is, okay, this is the electromagnetic torque, okay, should be greater than or equal to the load torque. So this is the stable operation of the motor. We don't want to operate the machine in the unstable operating mode. We want to operate the motor in the stable operation or standard steady state condition. The speed should be increases progressively, okay, but not decreases that condition. Case 1 and case 2, we didn't get. So I will take one example now. I will explain that part very clearly. Just these are the three conditions. What is the relation between the electromagnetic torque and the load torque in the motor? I will tell you this. I will explain very clear by taking one example. Okay, let us take one question. Question is, a DC motor is operating under steady state condition. At rated voltage and rated speed. Okay, so if mechanical load is removed, from shaft of the motor, then the back EMF and armature current. Armature current of the motor would be, okay, options are given, like option A would be respectively 4th are increase, option B both are decrease, option C one is a increase, other one is decrease. Okay, armature current, back EMF is increase, armature current decrease. So back EMF the decreases and armature current will be increase. Okay, like, so this is the one of the question, and this is the objective point of view. Sometimes same question you can ask in the interviews. Okay, this question is a, so how does motor moves from, okay, this is a, how does the motor moves, this question meaning is a, how does motor moves from, okay, from the load, from the loaded condition to loaded condition to, okay, next one, loaded condition to the no load condition, no load condition. So next, okay, other similar way. So how does motor moves from, okay, same questions, how does motor moves from one steady state operating point to two, one steady state operating point to another steady state operating point, steady state operating point. Okay, one steady state operating point is a full load, another steady state operating point is the no load. Back EMF increase and the armature current is a decreases. Okay, then what is the exactly what will happen? See, so initially we have a, okay, then what will happen? So in this question, first one, so under no, under full loaded condition, okay, under full load condition, so what is the, your DC motor is operating under steady state condition. So it means that electromagnetic torque 1 is equal to the load torque, okay, TL, okay, load torque TL here. So now at this condition, the speed of the motor, that is a N1. So back EMF of the motor, okay, this back EMF, so that is equal to EB1, okay, clear. So next one, armature current of the motor, okay, that is a IA1, so under steady state condition. So now mechanical load is removed from the shaft of the motors. So then what will happen? So whenever mechanical load is, so now this is the one steady state operating point. So when mechanical load, okay, TL is equal to zero, so then what about the torque here? So what about this condition? So that is a electromag here, when TL is equal to zero, the here this electromagnetic torque of the motor greater than the load torque. So due to which what will happen? So this is a, the due to this, the speed of the motor, the increases, okay, speed of the motor increases. So due to the accelerating, okay, accelerating here. So now it is a electromagnetic torque is equal to load torque. So why? Because here there is no load, only frictional torque is a present, okay, TFR. So that's why electromagnetic torque is greater than the frictional torque. So that speed of the motor increases due to the acceleration of the motor. So when speed is increases, okay, then speed is increases. So what will happen? The speed is directly proportional to the back EMF. So here this back EMF, okay, suppose you can write. So this back EMF of the motor, we know that directly proportional to the speed and the flux. So flux is a constant, right? So but increased in the speed, okay, increases the back EMF of the motor, so that back EMF so will be increased. So here increased in the back EMF, then what will happen? The armature current Ia is equal to, so V minus Eb divided by Ra value here. So increased in the back EMF, okay, increased in the back EMF, so decreases the armature current, okay. So now decreased in the armature current, then what will happen in the electromagnetic torque? So electromagnetic torque directly proportional to the flux and armature current. So as long as armature current decreases, okay, decreases, so electromagnetic torque decreases from the load torque to so frictional torque, okay, TFR. So when frictional torque, okay, decrease whenever, so this is a equal to, okay, at this condition, so when the here this electromagnetic torque equal to so frictional torque, so motor draws the, okay, this armature current, okay, armature current that is a Ia2, so to drive this frictional torque. So now again the back EMF is equal to, we will get Eb2 here. So next one, so the rotates the speed of the rotation, so now that is equal to N2 values here. So now what are the conclusions here? Okay, what is the conclusions? So this operating point is a, so second operating point, okay, the another first operating point, okay, this is the first operating point. So now this operating point is the second operating point. So now by comparing these two, so here is a armature current Ia2, okay, less than the Ia1, okay. So next one, back EMF of the motor Eb2, so here is a, okay, Eb2 here, so this one is a back EMF, what will happen, greater than the Eb, so our Eb1 is Ia2 is a less than Ia1, so big Eb2, Eb2 less than Eb1. Okay, compare this one. Ia1 is a greater than the Ia2. Very small amount of the current. So now what about the speed here? So in order to drive this one, Eb2 greater than the Eb1. The speed is also, okay, speed is greater than the N1. So under no load condition, this the speed is a very high. Full load condition, this one is the full load speed and this one is the no load speed. So under no load condition, it rotates at high speed. So back EMF is more. So these are the conclusions from this question. So now what is the answer for this question? Okay, answer for this question here. Back EMF will be, okay, back EMF will be increase and armature current is the decreases here. Okay, like. So this is the motor moves from the one steady state operating point to another steady state operating. I repeat once again, see, whenever mechanical load is removed from the shaft of the motor, the electromagnetic torque greater than the frictional torque, so that the motor speed of the motor increases due to the accelerating effect. So when the speed is decreased, either speed is increases, back EMF of the motor will be increased. So increased in the back EMF decreases the armature current. So as armature current is a decreases, so electromagnetic torque will be decreased. So as long as armature current is a decreases, electromagnetic torque decreases. So decreases from the loaded to the frictional torque. So whenever this electromagnetic torque equal to the frictional torque, so motor draws the armature current of Ia2 and rotates constantly at a speed of the N2. Okay, so this is nothing but how does motor moves from one steady state operating point to another steady state operating point. Okay, is that clear, everyone? Okay, so remaining part we'll discuss in the next class. So this is official creatrix channel. So creatrix Facebook and Telegram, this is the Telegram group. So please join in the channel. And next one, it is Unacademy Gate Telugu Telegram group. For class notes, please join in this channel. Okay, this is the different type of channels under the Unacademy. One is a creatrix gate, Unacademy Gate, Unacademy Gate Civil, Unacademy Gate Telugu, Electrical Junction, Unacademy Gate Questions, Unacademy Computer Science, Unacademy SSCJE, Engineering Foundation, and Engineering Patashala. Okay. Engineering Patashala. This is our channel. Please like, subscribe this channel. Okay. Thank you all. Thank you very much. Okay. All of you download the Unacademy learning app and access your pre-classes, pre-special classes. Thank you very much. Do you want to ask any more questions? Is that clear? This is a very, very important concept to analyze the characteristics of the DC motor. If you know this concept very clear, you can analyze the easily characteristics of the any DC motors. Okay. In the next class, we will discuss about all the questions based on. In the next class, we will discuss about the possible questions are gate and the ESC questions. ESC questions on these basic topics, basic concepts. In the next class, we will discuss about gate and ESC questions on the basic of operating principle, working EMF equation, torque equation, working of the motor. All the basic concepts will discuss the all possible questions in the gate and ESC. Thank you guys. Thank you very much.